Listening to Ronald Reagan's words reminds me I do want another Ronald Reagan back, and I am looking for him. I was going to make a very brief introduction, made briefer by what Ronald Reagan said, because he pointed out half of the challenge we face today to avoid what would be socialized medicine and the horrors of that would entail. We have the other challenge, which is probably not really envisioned 50 years ago, that if we get this wrong on healthcare, not just Medicare, but healthcare, we will not only not be able to provide state-of-the-art medical care for Americans, but we will literally bankrupt the country in the process of trying. That all of us who have thought we were conservatives, and I started with Goldwater and Reagan and Newt, and I think I'm a pretty good conservative, but we were not alert enough to the risk of deficit. And what has made us all alert is a public that's become aroused. And likewise, what's going to make new federalism work is states' attorneys generals and publics that are aroused to defend it. Because we were kind of just sort of, you know, we gave, with the exception of 1995, when my old boss Newt actually cut federal spending by $50 billion, which was a huge fight. That was our big fight with Clinton. By and large, we just kind of bumped along. We spent less than the D's, but we weren't alive. I wasn't alive to my God, look where these numbers are going to go. And we didn't become alive to it until the public became alive. So, I mean, to me, this is so much, you know, small d democracy or representative constitutional government in action, that if the public doesn't energize the politicians and the staffers to do our duties, it won't get done. We'll just kind of coast along, and which is why it's so exciting now to see the attorneys general beginning to vindicate the rights.